Hello students of standard 10th. Welcome to the history class. On your screen, chapter 9, heritage management. Dear students, because this particular text is very much lengthy, I have decided to or I have divided the text into three parts. So already we have done with the two parts of this particular text, that is heritage management. Okay, so something that we have covered up till now, I just want to discuss about it. That is, we have discussed 9.1 sources of history, their conservation and preservation. We have done some famous museums. We have studied 9.3 libraries and archives, and we have also discussed about 9.4 encyclopedias. Yes, in the previous class we have done encyclopedias, and just I will scroll the pages down. All this content, the teachings have been done in the previous teaching videos. You can just go through it, and today it's time for me to release chapter 9, heritage management, part 3. So today we'll deal with the part 3. Students, I tried my level best to send all the beautiful images of all the content that is in this particular text. In fact, it was very curious for me as well to find out those pictures, those images, and I have done it and I have forwarded it. Yes, so the previous video, that is chapter 9, heritage management, part 2, we discussed about the encyclopedias. Yeah, just make it a point that you listen to the videos completely, and today, here we take a start from do you know? Yeah. From here, I take a start today. Do you know? As we are dealing with 9.4 encyclopedias. Students, till now, something that we have discussed in the encyclopedias. Yes, as we are dealing with the topic heritage management, encyclopedias counts a lot. The role of encyclopedias is very significant as far as our heritage management is concerned. So students, at the beginning of this, we discussed about the types of encyclopedia, that is encyclopedic literature, means koshadruksha. Next, we discussed the indexes. So let us take a start from this encyclopedia. Just I'm giving you the something that we have already done. Okay. So here, Koshadrush literature. Then we discussed about the indexes. Then we discussed about the dictionaries. Yes. Then comprehensive encyclopedia, that is Vishwakosh. All these topics we have discussed in part 2 video, and how encyclopedias on history related subjects we deal with. And today it's time for us to take a start with do you know some special encyclopedias. So I take a start from here, and I text read the content from the screen, and wherever explanation is needed, I'll give it. So students, in the previous class, we discussed very much in detail about this, the volumes that includes the information based on the lives of individual mentioned in Vedic literature, including Shruti, Smriti, Sutras, Vedangas, Upanishads and also Puranas, Jain and Buddhist literature. We discussed in detail. If you remember, we have discussed the Three Ratnas and the Eightfold Path, that is the Ashtanga Marga, which is very much in Buddhism. And today we proceed further. Similarly, other two volumes contain biographies of individuals in the respected periods, and here, do you know? Some special encyclopedias, that is Sangeet Shastrakar va Kalavant Yansa Ithihas by Lakshman Dattatre Joshi. Next, Krantikaransa Charitrakosh by S. R. Date. It contains biographies and illustration of about 250 Indian revolutionaries. Number 3, Swatantra Sainik Charitrakosh by N. R. Phatak. It contains the biographies of those who suffered corporal punishment, that is imprisonment, and those who devoted their life for independence movement. So these are some special encyclopedias. So only they are introduced to you in this particular pink color inset. Then students, we move on to Sthalakosh. Sthal means place. Sthal. You know, sthal means place. In Marathi, sthal means place. And today we are going to study about the Sthalakosh. Geographic information is essential for historical studies. Yes, students, it is rightly said that history is because of geography. No geography means no history. Because as per the passing of the time and geographical changes, geographical boundaries, geographical information, we get to know the historical studies of that particular territory or that particular region or that particular provinces. So students, encyclopedias are giving information about historical places are available. So in Sthalakosh, what you get? The content that you will find in Sthalakosh is the information about the historical places. Okay, so number one is Sthana Pothi. Sthana Pothi. Pothi means again a book, but it is in a very old form, traditional form, so-called pothi. Pothi is a non-English word. Sthana pothi is a non-English word. Sthana means place and pothi means collective information brought together in one book. So 14th century CE is an encyclopedic text which is composed by Muni Vyas of Mahanubhav sect. It describes all those places visited by Chakradhar Swami, the founder of Mahanubhav sect. It gives us an inkling about Maharashtra in those days. It also gives details about the time, place and background of the events described in Leela Charitra. Hence, it is a very good source for writing about the life of Chakradhar Swami. Next, Prachin Bhartiya Sthalakosh, 1969. Siddheshwar Shastri Chitrav compiled this encyclopedic book. It provides information about various places mentioned in Vedic literature. Kautilya Arthashastra, Panini's Grammar, Valmiki Ramayana, Mahabharata, Puranas, Medieval Sanskrit Literature and Shabdakosh. Also in Jain and Buddhist literature, in Greek, Chinese, Persian literature. So students, this is what we do have in encyclopedia. All the informative material you will find in Prachin Bhartiya Sthalakosh. And very profound efforts are taken by Siddheshwar Shastri Chitrav to compile this book. To compile this encyclopedic book. Then students, it's Vishwakosh. Vishwakosh, the first Chief Minister of Maharashtra, Honorable Shri Yashwantrao Chavhan, initiated the compilation of Marathi Vishwakosh through Maharashtra Rajya Sahitya Sanskruti Mandal with a view to enhance the sphere of Marathi language and literature. Students, please take note, when it comes to a particular state, each state do have its own language, and it is the topmost priority of that state management, of that state administration, to take due care of the state language. So as we are in state of Maharashtra, and you know that Marathi speaking, Marathi language is the main language or is the state language of Maharashtra. Therefore, as far as Marathi language is concerned, as far as Marathi literature is concerned, due care has to be taken, has to be preserved, has to be conserved. Okay, and the initiatives are very much taken by the people, those who are at the ministry level. So, at times, Honorable Shri Yashwantrao Chavhan, he initiated the compilation of Marathi Vishwakosh through Maharashtra Rajya Sahitya Sanskruti Mandal. Please take note, this particular institution worked very hard to bring Marathi language and its literature to people. Moreover, this particular institution also helped with a view to enhance the spirit, the sphere of Marathi language. The work was started under the guidance of Tark Tirth. Please take note, Tark Tirth. Tark Lavne means to Tark Shastra. You must be knowing about it. To analyze something. Yeah. So some analogists, the Tark Tirth, Lakshman Shastri Joshi. His name is very much highlighted here. He stated and he gave a broad vision, a broad vista to Marathi language and its literature. So students, as far as the writings of Tark Tirth Lakshman Shastri Joshi is concerned, he guided this encyclopedia. It contains knowledge about all possible subjects in the world. It also contains very important entries about histories. Then student, Bhartiya Sanskruti Kosh. 10 volumes of Bhartiya Sanskruti Kosh were edited and published by Mahadev Shastri Joshi. These volumes contain information about Indian history, geography, various ethnics and lingual groups, local history of those groups, their festivals and other cultural aspects. So when it comes to Sanskruti, that is the culture of India, we say Bhartiya Sanskruti Kosh. And all the different cultural aspects like the ethnics, the lingual groups, the local history, the festivals, the traditions and all other related cultural aspects are discussed, are stated very clearly in Bhartiya Sanskruti Kosh. Then it is Samadhnya Kosh. There are encyclopedic texts explaining the terminology, for instance, colonism, globalization, etc. of history. We have discussed the word meaning of terminology in the previous class. Just go and find out. Such texts are very useful for teachers of history. School, college and university teachers of history can find ample opportunities in the field of publication of encyclopedias. So students, as far as knowledge of encyclopedia is concerned, it is very much suggested to all the teachers, all the people, those who have taken teaching as their vocation, as their profession. So, these encyclopedias are kept available in the libraries for the teacher's reference. And it is utmost duty of every teacher to visit those libraries where these encyclopedias are made available for the teachers for gaining much more knowledge or adding some information to their knowledge. So students, please take note, the teachers of history, school, colleges and university teachers of history can find ample opportunities in the field of publication of encyclopedias. So this is also one of the professional opportunities for all the teachers, those who are very much with the history subject. And they can explore more if they join this publication of encyclopedias. Moreover, students, encyclopedias of all types requires experts in history. Every subject has a developmental history. Scholars of history can contribute significantly. Encyclopedias of various types significantly to encyclopedias of various types. After studying this textbook, you must have noted that with specialization in history, one can get access to several career opportunities in various fields. You can choose your future career with the help of the information in this textbook. So students, as we have reached to the end part of this particular text, history, specifically history, students, please take note, as we discussed about the Samadhya Kosh are the encyclopedic text which explains the meaning of various important things in the present era, such as globalization and colonialism. That is Samadhya Kosh. Okay. And yes, while dealing with Bhartiya Sanskriti Kosh, this particular encyclopedia of Indian culture, it explains that Bhartiya Sanskriti Kosh pays stress in objectivity, though an academic exercise of history. So students, please take note. Right now I am reading this particular text, and this text knowledge is very much from Bhartiya Sanskriti Kosh. Yes. So that's what about we have studied in this text. Yes, we have studied about the Vishwakosh. Vishwakosh means treasury of knowledge. This book is said to be so affluent in its content, consisting of various informative collections. The meaning of Vishwakosh itself means treasure of knowledge of all over the world in abundance. So this is what we have studied in Vishwakosh. You will find that these particular encyclopedias, so-called Vishwakosh, do have the treasure of knowledge of all over the world in abundance. So students, here it's time to end with the history text teaching. And definitely I would like to give some good concluding words for all my students, that yes, this particular text reading will definitely help you out as far as your future career is concerned. Okay. So, yes. On this note, as I complete the heritage management text, students, please take note. The motto behind learning heritage management is to equip yourself to work in the cultural heritage sector, which offers a wide range of exciting opportunities in museums, local authorities, heritage agencies, organizations, and consultancies. Moreover, students, exploring the multidisciplinary nature of the heritage environment. Yes, this is also conveyed to the youths to preserve the heritage assets of a nation in a way that ensures the connection and interdependency among the heritage assets and people, those who practice of heritage of management. So students, please take note, as we are dealing with heritage management, among the heritage assets and people, the practice of heritage of management is evolving into a rich interdisciplinary field in which conservation science meets management knowledge, प्लीज राइट दिस सेंटेंस और स्टेटमेंट. कंजर्वेशन साइंस मीट्स मैनेजमेंट नॉलेज. देयरफॉर स्टूडेंट्स आई कंक्लूड विद दिस चैप्टर सेइंग दैट इंडिया इज एन एंशियंट कंट्री. We are blessed with a beautiful heritage. We are solely responsible to preserve the same so that our future generation also get to see and experience the same. So students, here I'm just scrolling down the page. These are the exercises which you have to complete in your notebooks. Yes. With this, I complete history teaching, and the next class we will be meeting with political science chapter 4. Yes, we'll have political science chapter 4, social and political movements. Okay, in the next video you will get that particular lesson. So students, please complete these notes. Heritage management, you please complete it. With this, I complete this text. Okay, till we meet in the next video teaching class, take good care of yourself. Bye. Thank you.